think one of the greatest benefits with shifting to inquiry is that it engages students because it takes what they know about the world and has them relate what they know about the world to learning about the different aspects of social studies. So I think it's inherently engaging. I think as human beings, we're naturally curious. So inquiry is a very natural thing to do, and I'm glad that we're embracing it. I think what I saw Ms. Rogers do so well was engage the students with their own thinking.
Does anybody want to share a question that they might have had? Brady Kate, what question might you have had?
I'm wondering what region like they belong to.
What region they might have belonged to.
And she created space for the students to raise their own questions. She helped them build their understanding in a way that made sense for them. So I liked how she was creating that culture of inquiry in a risk-free way. The students felt very secure and safe to identify questions that will help them learn more about the American Indians.
It's really nice to see teachers putting all the pieces together. So we've been talking about the different pieces of the inquiry art, from questioning to applying disciplinary tools, evaluating sources, and then taking informed action. So it's exciting to see them to be able to break the inquiry arc apart and hone in on different pieces, but then to put all the pieces together and do a whole inquiry. So it's very flexible in that sense. And what we saw today is that students will arrive at what you want them to know if you give them the space to do it.
Student engagement has improved. The students feel more challenged. They have more ownership of their learning. And they're excited to not just be learning history in a passive way, but in a more active way.
I guess the transition has developed from not just lecturing students, and you have to know this because this is your history. It's now, culturally, I can learn this, and it is relevant to all groups of people. We all have to know about political point of views. We all have to know how to work together. And so that's what history does. It's the college support base, and it's a civic duty to know social studies. And they now see it.
Being in classrooms and observing classrooms, the role of the teacher seems to be one of the big changes and shifts that I've noticed recently. Looking back on how I was taught social studies, it was mainly the teacher was in front of the room, the students at their desk taking notes, maybe some PowerPoint teaching, maybe reading some books for us as a read aloud. Now when you go into a classroom, the teacher is facilitating the lessons, walking around, having conversations with students. Students are reading, they're writing, they're illustrating things that go along with the unit that they're studying at the time. The teacher has taken the role of learner themselves. Not only are they a learner in the classroom with their students, they also have become more experts on content knowledge, trying to seek out more of the background information, seeing themselves as asking questions of history, because I think a lot of that, just from my perspective, I wasn't taught that way, and now learning that way alongside teachers, it makes me want to know more, and it helps to put those puzzle pieces together, I think, for teachers, but also as kids.